I understand that a lot of these challenges from the higher level, the policy support from the government is there. But the challenges are deeply hidden into the execution of these policy guidelines. And there are multiple stakeholders who are a part of this execution timeline or a road to implement this program. And I recently had a meeting with the World Bank, and they are going to come up with the new residential financing line through SBI. And the challenges that we saw over there was not only the execution front from the SBI end, that is the bank network and the employees, whether they are trained on this sector, whether this sector is treated as a priority sector for them or not. The bank employees themselves are not promoting in providing the financing line to anybody who's asking for it. And the kind of support which is required is not only from the demand side, but also from the supply side also. That is the kind of technical training that has to be provided in the market to install good quality systems. And the kind of the net metering installations and the paperwork and the documentation which is there, which the DISCOMs ask specifically while application of getting a particular solar plant approved by them. So the execution challenges are surmountable. And in order to address them, in order to understand what are the other deeply hidden challenges in the solar segment, I would like to understand from somebody who has been into the residential solar business for quite long, and I would understand it from Mr. Dhawal, who has been working from Goldie Solar and has been instrumental in the residential segment, if he can throw some light on it.
Thank you, Saili. Good afternoon, friends. This is Dhawal from Goldie Solar. Basically, Manish sir ne abhi bataya ki Gujarat policy जो 600 मेगावाट की डिक्लेयर हुई है रेसिडेंशियल्स के लिए, तो उसमें बेसिकली एक प्रॉब्लम ये है कि जो पीडीआई कॉल है, काफ़ी प्रोसेस में, लेंथी प्रोसेस में टाइम निकल गया है. अब पूरा सप्लाई एज अ पैनल मैन्युफैक्चरर, आज पूरा सप्लाई लास्ट क्वार्टर में आ रहा है आज के डेट में. तो अपने को पता है कि लास्ट क्वार्टर में बेसिकली बिग स्केल प्रोजेक्ट्स में भी काफ़ी सप्लाईज वगैरह रहता है, तो पैनल सप्लाई करना काफ़ी डिफ़िकल्ट हो रहा है आज के डेट में लास्ट क्वार्टर्स के लिए. तो एक ये प्रॉब्लम है. दूसरा है कि जो मुकेश सर ने बताया कि ये जो प्रोजेक्ट्स जितने भी आ रहे हैं आज के डेट में गुजरात में, उसमें क्या क्या चेंजेस हो सकते हैं नेक्स्ट टाइम के लिए. बेसिकली काफ़ी ईपीसी कंपनीज गुजरात में ऐसी है कि पर्टिकुलर रेसिडेंशियल स्कीम के लिए ही खड़ी हुई है आज की डेट में. लास्ट अप्रैल से लेके अब तक उनके पास कुछ काम नहीं था, और अभी जो लेंथी प्रोसेस हो रही है उसकी वजह से आज के डेट में भी उनका इंस्टॉलेशन का वर्क शुरू नहीं हुआ है, और मार्च तक जैसे बताया कि 150 से 200 मेगावाट का ही कंप्लीशन हो पाएगा. उसकी वजह से जितने भी पैनल मैन्युफैक्चरर है, इन्वर्टर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग कंपनीज है, जो लोग प्लान बना के बैठे हुए थे कि भाई अपने को इतना मेगावाट का सप्लाई करना है, ये करना है, तो वो सक्सेसफुली कम्प्लीट नहीं हो पा रहा है. तो एक रिक्वेस्ट है कि जितने भी नए प्रोजेक्ट्स आ रहे हैं, तो फर्स्ट क्वार्टर में ही अगर उसका अनाउंसमेंट हो जाता है तो पूरे साल के लिए अपने पास काम रहता है, और पूरे साल का जो टारगेट रहता है अराउंड 600 मेगावाट का जो टारगेट है वो इजीली हम लोग अचीव कर सकते हैं.
थैंक यू मिस्टर धवल. मिस्टर मनीष, डू यू वांट टू थ्रो सम लाइट ऑन द रेजिडेंशियल चैलेंजेस आल्सो?
रेजिडेंशियल के अंदर अभी जो चैलेंजेस अभी आ रहे हैं, जैसा मिस्टर धवल ने बताया कि हम लोगों को प्रोसीजरल के अंदर, मतलब प्रोजेक्ट लगाना हमारे लिए, अगर पाँच रेजिडेंशियल की बात करूँ तो 5 किलोवाट का जो एक एवरेज प्रोजेक्ट होता है वो लगाना हार्डली एक दिन का काम है एक इंस्टॉलर के लिए, और उसका पीडीआई से लेके मीटर लगाने तक का 1.5 महीने का प्रोसेस है, और उसमें कितनी मैन पावर, कितना इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर जा रहा है, हमारे लिए बहुत इशूज़ आ रहे हैं. और साथ के साथ में जो एक हम लोगों ने रिप्रेजेंट किया था, मुकेश सर की भी नॉलेज में है, शीतल भाई की भी नॉलेज में है, कि अभी जो पीडीआई हो रही है, कुछ टोटल 5 जो डिस्कॉम है, 5 डिस्कॉम के अंदर से 2 डिस्कॉम जो है सिर्फ पैनल का पीडीआई कर रहे हैं, बाकी 3 डिस्कॉम जो है सारे आइटम का, इन्वर्टर का और जो अपना स्ट्रक्चर का, उसका पीडीआई कर रहे हैं. क्या उनके पास इतना इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर है? नहीं है उनके पास, वो और आगे फर्दर डिले करने वाला है पूरे प्रोसेस को। दूसरा, अगर मैं अभी इस प्लेटफॉर्म से रिक्वेस्ट करूँगा जो मुकेश भाई को या उनको, कि अगर जो पीडीआई पैनल की जा रही है, अभी की जा रही है कि मैंने एक कंटेनर का ऑर्डर दिया अडानी को या बारी को या किसी को भी ऑर्डर दिया, उसके बाद में वो मैं जीवनल को भेजता हूँ, जीवनल आगे जो है कंसर्न उसको भेजता है जिसके एरिया में फैक्ट्री आती है, ये पूरे प्रोसेस में 10 से 12 दिन लग जाते हैं और ये पूरा टाइम वेस्ट हो रहा है। इससे बढ़िया अगर इनकी जो फैक्ट्रियाँ हैं, जो मैन्युफैक्चरर हैं, हार्डली 8 या 10 मैन्युफैक्चरर हैं, उन्हीं की फैक्ट्री पे जाके उनकी कैपेसिटी है, अडानी ने बोला मेरा 50 मेगावाट तैयार है तो 50 मेगावाट जाके सर्टिफाई कर दिया, ये पीडीआई करे हुए डीसीआर कंटेंट के पैनल हैं, जिसको जिस डिस्कॉम में लेना हो सर्टिफाइड पैनल हैं, जिसको जिस डिस्कॉम में लेना हो लो, वारी ने बोला मेरा 10 मेगावाट तैयार है, 10 मेगावाट एक साथ में जाके कर दिया उसका पीडीआई ख़त्म। तो ये जो प्रोसेस है वो थोड़ा सरल हो सकता है और जो टेंडर की टर्म्स एंड कंडीशन है वो भी फुलफिल हो सकती है। अगर हम रियली सीरियस हैं सरकार के, मोदी सरकार के जो टारगेट है उसको पूरा करने के लिए, ये 600 मेगावाट को और आगे फास्ट करने के लिए, तो एक ये बहुत बड़ी हर्डल है कि सिर्फ पीडीआई के अंदर सिर्फ पैनल का किया जाए, सारे डिस्कॉम, चाहे अभी पीजीवीसीएल का रूल अलग है, यूजीवीसीएल का रूल अलग है, डीजीवीसीएल का रूल अलग है, टोरेंट का रूल अलग है, सबके रूल अलग अलग है। अभी तो हमको ये भी पता नहीं है कि जो हमारा पैसा 30% एवरेज में लगा रहे हैं ये हमको सब्सिडी कैसे मिलेगी, ये हमको नहीं पता है आज के तारीख में। यहाँ जितने आदमी बैठे सबके मन के अंदर यूँ है कि हम लगा तो देंगे, हमारा पैसा वापस कैसे आएगा हमको पता नहीं है। अगर वो पैसा नहीं आया तो और सारा साइकिल रुक जाएगा, सबका फंडिंग रुक जाएगा और आगे काम ही नहीं होगा, फिर वो 150-200 मेगावाट जो मैं बोल रहा हूँ वो भी पूरा नहीं हो पाएगा। दिस इज माय व्यू।
वेरी वेल सेड। सब्सिडी इश्यूज हैव बीन माउंटिंग ऑन टॉप फॉर क्वाइट लॉन्ग एंड वी अंडरस्टैंड दैट फ्रॉम द एक्सपीरियंसेस ऑफ डिफरेंट डेवलपर्स दैट द सब्सिडी इज नॉट इवन डिस्पर्स्ड in a span of 1 or 2 years, and that is what deterring all these developers to come ahead and install for a long term perspective. And amongst all these issues, I think the consumer is the one who is suffering, and he does not understand, he is not aware of all the policies, and he is confused right now. And the kind of delays that we are seeing from the subsidy disbursement to net meter installation, the consumer is the one who is asking us, when would he start getting solar energy, and what kind of backing does he have for next 5 or 25 years? And that comes from the good product installation, from the quality product installation. And next, I would like to call upon Mr. Vinod, if he can throw some light on his experiences on the consumer demand perspective. What kind of challenges is he facing, and has he been able to make the consumers aware of the challenges in this particular industry?
Yeah, I will intervene. Actually, this is a bogus news that since 2 years subsidies are pending. If any case present in this forum with a 2 years thing, we would really like to see and address the concern, because as of now, all money are disbursed and released. So hardly 6 months would be the maximum period for which there would be the process. Yeah, we'll definitely would like to take up, because of there must be some technical issue or something like that. Otherwise, we have cleared each and every file by sitting in the office day and night. So that is the one thing I would like to clarify on the Shaili's point. Thank you.
Thank you, Shelly. So this is Vinod here. I represent Havells India Limited. And so we are a front-end consumer-oriented company. And, you know, and even in solar residential systems, jaise hum yahan pe baat kar rahe hain, policy issues ke baare mein, subsidy ke baare mein, and, you know, and other aspects. I think the most important aspect which needs to be looked into is that how easy or difficult it is for a consumer to go for a solar system currently. And I think what I have realized and what I have interacted or what I have seen is that currently it's very difficult and it's very confusing, because for a consumer you're talking about something which runs for 25 years and it's an assimilation of different manufactured products. Wo chalega, nahi chalega, jo de rahe hain wo rahenge, nahi rahenge 25 saal tak. So I think there's a lot of, confusions in the heads of consumer. And that is why we are seeing the rooftop market currently, is at about 4 gigawatt, and the residential is hardly, a number in the total capacity. And the aspiration is 40 gigawatts, so which is very high in terms of, till 2022. So I think there needs to be a lot of consumer education, customer education, and also there is a lack of confidence even from the banking segment in terms of how the systems are going to work. So even for a consumer, when the consumer requests for a financing option or an EMI option or a loan option, banks don't come forward to give that. There are a lot of banking support which happens in utility sector, and with companies like Amplus and other OPEX players, there's been a lot of push in even in commercial and industrial segment. But the residential segment is something which is not getting affected because of that, because people have not had that confidence whether the systems will eventually work for 25 years. Is my money safe? And considering the macro environment of credit issues, what we are having, it's further come down. So I think this is where, as brands, we have sort of owners where we are working for the last 7 to 8 months since we have launched our own brand of inverters, is we are working with various, medium, large, small EPCs, system integrators as partners, where we are trying to communicate to customers, consumers, SMEs, as well as, residential customers through, ATL, BTL activities, trying to go and explain to them why they should go for solar. Of course, now a lot of people understand why they should go for solar, thanks to government policies, newspaper headlines, and stuff like that. But there's a lot of apprehension, right? Because if my father has to buy a solar system, and if I'm not from solar industry, I think it's very confusing where he will go, which is unlike, other brands, other systems. You have a lot of brands to go for. And I think that is where it's lacking. I think the policy issues, I'm sure the government is working on it. I'm sure the subsidy issues are being worked on it. But I think the larger issue as an industry where we have to focus, at the end of the day, is industry will be driven by the end consumer. If the consumer doesn't buy, no amount of policy is going to support or help. And I think that confidence needs to be really infused. And I think that will only be infused by good products, good companies, good brands, and not on price and how much subsidy we are going to get and how cheaper it is. I think that is where the challenge in my point of view is.
Can I add something?
Yes.
As Mr. Shetal said, this platform is for brainstorming. So, क्या सब्सिडी की जरूरत है रेजिडेंशियल पे? अब आज के 3 साल पहले सब्सिडी की जरूरत थी, जब एवरेज प्राइस 75,000 रुपये पर किलोवाट था. लेकिन क्या आज एवरेज 45,000 के भाव में सब्सिडी की जरूरत है? सब्सिडी के अंदर बहुत सारे लिमिटेशन, बहुत सारे राइडर्स आते हैं. मेरे हिसाब से मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि उसके ऊपर हमको दोबारा सोचना चाहिए गवर्नमेंट को. एक ज़माना था जब सोलर वाटर हीटर के ऊपर सब्सिडी थी 90% तक, तब भी लोग सोलर वाटर हीटर नहीं लगाते थे. आज सोलर वाटर हीटर के ऊपर सब्सिडी नहीं है, अवेयरनेस आ चुकी है. सोलर वाटर हीटर अपने आप बिकता है, जिसको लगाना है वो लगाता है और उसको उसकी पैरिटी बैठती है. सोलर पावर सिस्टम के ऊपर भी ऐसा स्टेज आ चुका है, कट ऑफ पॉइंट आ चुका है, कि अगर गवर्नमेंट सब्सिडी ना देवे, या सब्सिडी देने का दूसरा तरीका हो सकता है कि जितना पावर प्रोड्यूस किया उतनी सब्सिडी डिस्कॉम देवे. तो आज जो किसी भी भाव के अंदर कुछ भी क्वालिटी का सामान लग रहा है, कुछ भी सर्विस नहीं आ रही है, सिर्फ लगा देने से मतलब है जनरेशन आ रहा है कि नहीं आ रहा है, उसकी जगह अगर उसको जनरेशन बेस्ड डिस्कॉम उसको क्रेडिट दे हुए, जैसे बहुत सारी कंट्रीज के अंदर है, यूएस के अंदर शायद ये सिस्टम है, इन यूरोप के अंदर भी यही सिस्टम है, अगर वो कर दिया जावे तो काफ़ी अच्छा रहे. दूसरा ये पॉसिबल है अगर गवर्नमेंट स्टिल, क्योंकि ये MNRE दिल्ली का सब्जेक्ट है, गुजरात का सब्जेक्ट नहीं है, वहाँ से गवर्न होती है पॉलिसी. लेकिन अगर साथ के साथ में अगर ये कर दिया जावे कि यस सब्सिडी देनी है तो DBT से दीजिए, गवर्नमेंट का मैंडेट है, गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया का मैंडेट है. हम चैनल पार्टनर्स का पैसा क्यों इन्वॉल्व, क्यों फंसाने का? ये चीज जो है, अगर शीतल भाई या मुकेश भाई इसके ऊपर कोई लाइट डाल सके, इस सजेशन के ऊपर, तो वी वुड अप्रिशिएट.
नहीं, आपका DBT का और जनरेशन बेस्ड इंसेंटिव का दोनों सजेशन बहुत ही अच्छे हैं, और वी वुड लाइक टू वेलकम सम फॉर्मल submission on this aspect from industry in general through your federation or something like that. And this would really can be a game changer in this sector. And actually, ultimately, what we want is the 25-year long life of the system, which is once installed. And only quality system will install if there will be constant monitoring and the feedback. Because I have seen out of, even presently, we have some more than 450 channel partner, but there is a challenging task for us even to evaluate the performance of every channel partner. And we have observed some lacuna in the beginners or the new players coming in with less amount of experience or expertise. So there must be some value to the experts and the quality installer. And we really appreciate, to convert this appreciation into policy, we really would like to work upon. So very good suggestion, Manish ji.
Yeah, I think, consumer is looking for a long-term reliable system. I think a solar system, if I look at from a perspective, is actually an investment tool, right? You don't invest in any ABC companies, right? I mean, in share market, you always definitely see which companies to invest. And you are investing on some system, jo aapka expectation hai ki 25 saal tak chalega. So I think instead of, just working on, price points and subsidy, because even with subsidy for a 5 kilowatt system or 3 kilowatt system, it is not a very, very cheap system. It's still an expensive system. It is not affordable with each and everybody, right? Aapko ghar ki jagah chahiye, aapko chhat chahiye, and stuff like that. So we are talking about people who have money, who are willing to invest, but they want a reliable system to work. I think the focus should more go from the policy sector also, that how we can ensure that the customer is protected for 25 years, that the system will work.
I would like to add something to Mr. Shetal's, like that. You people have, like this year in this tender, more than 500 channel partners. And it's very difficult and challenging task for you to monitor what is the quality of the channel partner. Earlier, in about 2 years back, there was a entry barrier or there was a grading of the channel partners. The MNRE used to give the ratings, so like from 1 to 5 and A to C, 5A. So there should be any entry barrier so that people can recognize the good people. They can differentiate between the good channel partner or between the good channel partner and then who can provide the good services. There should be any mechanism from MNRE side.
What I would, I have a suggestion, I don't know how it is taken up. I think as an industry, we should work on some, framework. If you look at any product, say lighting, you have a lighting standard, right? If you want to put a light in this room, you have a standard how much illumination should happen. Unfortunately, we don't have any standards in solar. You can install, there is no standards on, nobody, we will not know how much cable sizing to be followed, what about DBs to be used. People don't use even distribution boxes. So I think as an industry, I think the onus is on the industry, since the industry itself is a new industry or it's a technologically changing industry. I think there needs to be some standards so that, consumer interests are protected, because tomorrow you might have a situation where the consumer might say that I don't want solar system because my neighbor has installed and uska solar system chal nahi raha to main kyun lagaun. So I think that is we need to move towards that direction.
Thank you, Mr. Vinod. I understand the overall theme which is coming around is on how to solve these challenges through technology. Through technology, if we can map all the solar plants installed all across India and the generation which can be tracked, through that, we can track the generation-based incentive that can be given to these customers. Now, technology itself is in a very nascent stage in India, and there are very few players who are focusing on the power of data to understand the generation, we understand the variation of generation with the weather, and how that data can be made available to all the different institutions who are taking part in the decision making of whether a subsidy should be given or a generation based incentive should be given. I would like to understand more on what are the consumer focused activities that different players are doing right now. I would like to understand from Mr. Dhawal also, if he can point out how he's interacting with these customers, with the customers, and what are the challenges that customers are seeing, and how are you answering those challenges?
Basically, हम लोग panel manufacturing companies हैं, ज़्यादा EPC का इतना नहीं है हमारा, right? पर customer आज की date में क्या है कि educate हो गया है, awareness काफ़ी आई हुई है लोगों में. अब कौन सा panel लोगे? अब तक ये ठीक था, आप कौन सा सेल यूज़ कर रहे हो पैनल में? आज के दिन ये एक क्वेश्चन भी आ रहा है सबके माइंड में. तो काफ़ी ईपीसी कंपनीज में जो डीसीआर की वजह से जो प्रॉब्लम्स आए हुए हैं, प्रॉब्लम्स तो नहीं बोल सकते, लिमिटेड सप्लाई है सेल्स का. कि आज के 600 मेगावाट का गुजरात का टेंडर है, उसके अलावा काफ़ी अलग स्टेट में भी डीसीआर के प्रोजेक्ट्स आए हुए हैं, तो सेल्स सप्लाई नहीं है. जैसे सर ने बताया था कि 3 गीगावाट की ऑल ओवर इंडिया की सेल मैन्युफैक्चरिंग कैपेसिटी है, उसके सामने 2022 तक मल्टीपल ऑफ गीगावाट के प्रोजेक्ट्स आ रहे हैं आज की डेट में. तो सेल सप्लाई नहीं है, कस्टमर एक बार पेमेंट देने के बाद काफ़ी प्रॉब्लम्स है कि क्यों प्लांट नहीं लग रहे हैं, राइट? पेमेंट दे दिया है, सब कुछ हो गया है, 1.5 महीना हो गया 2 महीना हो गया, प्लांट क्यों नहीं लग रहा है? जैसे मनीष सर ने बताया कि PDI की प्रोसेस है पूरा, 1.5 महीना 2 महीना PDI स्ट्रक्चर क्लियरेंस, पैनल क्लियरेंस, ये सब में लग जाते हैं. तो इसमें एक सॉल्यूशन यही है कि एज अ पैनल मैन्युफैक्चरर हम लोग बोल देते हैं कि भाई मेरे पास 5 मेगावाट का मॉड्यूल रेडी है, आप लोग वन टाइम इंस्पेक्शन करके सीरियल नंबर ब्लॉक करवा लीजिए और उसमें हम लोग आपको सप्लाई करते रहते हैं. तो एक सजेशन है कि डिस्कॉम और अपने PGVCL जितने भी डिस्कॉम्स है, GUNL है, उनको एक पैनल्स के लिए पर्टिकुलर ये चीज़ अपनानी चाहिए कि वन टाइम इंस्पेक्शन करके उसके अगेंस्ट में मॉड्यूल सप्लाई हम लोग कर पाए. क्योंकि जैसे जैसे मार्च करीब आता रहेगा, नंबर ऑफ सप्लाई काफ़ी बढ़ेगा, DCR है, नॉन DCR है उसमें. और आज मैं गोल्डी की फैक्ट्री पे आके आप देखें, मोर देन 15 मेगावाट का DCR मॉड्यूल बन के पड़ा हुआ है, काफ़ी इंस्पेक्शन भी हुए हैं, विदाउट इंस्पेक्शन के बना के पड़े हुए हैं, सप्लाई हो नहीं रहा है, PDI पेंडिंग है, राइट? तो इसके लिए एक है कि एग्रेसिवली PDI की प्रोसेस को कुछ रीडिफाइन किया जाए और उसमें कुछ सॉल्यूशन निकाला जाए.
थैंक यू मिस्टर धवल. आई वुड लाइक टू अंडरस्टैंड फ्रॉम मिस्टर अंकित आल्सो ऑन द चैलेंजेस दैट बेनिफिशियरीज आर पोजिंग इन टर्म्स ऑफ सोलर इंस्टॉलेशंस.
So Shelly, you asked about that what customer experience is. So when we talk about customer experience in solar industry, is like they are confused. When they place an order, they feel like, yeah, I have given money, I have given token amount, and my plant will going to install in some days. Even as a EPC player, we convince them that plant will going to install in 2 to 3 months. But when we tell them that our panel is in inspection, our structure is in inspection, and this process is going on, and this process is going on, they will not listen because they have invested and they have given some money. And when customers give some money, he feels like, you know, I am the king. So he has given money to the company, and now the plant will be there in 1 month or 2 month timeline. But where we are also helpless, where we can't do something. So in that whole process, the EPC player will going to be in the wrong shape or a wrong figure, that he is misguiding, or he is not doing on the time, or he is not going to supply on time, or he is putting up not the same effort which he is putting on the commercial side or the other clients, right? So this process, if you know it is a big policy and everyone is working very hard to achieve the target, so if the whole process can be advertised also, or can be marketed to the customers or to the clients, that this process takes time and it will take 4 months, because like the process is fixed now and we can't do anything on that part. But that customer can be educated that after giving the order, this much time will going to take. So then it will be easy for the customers to get a confidence on the EPC player also. This business is completely a reference business. Whenever if your first customer is not happy, he will not going to give you reference, right? So that we all have to work on the customer experience part. So in all the industry, customer experience is the biggest thing which every industry is working in this current scenario. So for improving the customer experience, client needs to be educated that this is the process involved in the whole solar rooftop installation, and this much time will be there, and we are on the track to provide you the best system available in the market. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Ankit. Mr. Narya, can you shed some light on how the visibility of the platform, the visibility of what benefits a customer is getting can be provided to the customer, and how that can actually solve the challenges that are existing in this industry?
Right now, customer is very much aware, and they are asking what is the polycrystalline, what is PERC cell, what is monopERC, and what is half-cut cell. They are just referencing each and every project with the base price, which is discovered by around 34,000 rupees. So, first, achha, half-cut cell aata hai. Okay. तो 34,000 में मिल जाएगा, वेरी गुड, बट इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल. सो कस्टमर आर नाउ गेटिंग अवेयर, बट दे आर नॉट प्रीटी मच अवेयर दैट टेक्नोलॉजी इज डिफरेंट, कॉस्ट इज डिफरेंट, एंड कमिंग टू दिस स्टैंडर्डाइजेशन, रेसिडेंशियल एंड सीएनआई सेक्टर आर डिफरेंट सेक्टर्स. Because in CNI, we have to work with some multinational companies where they have set very much high safety standards. So we need to provide lifelines, walkways, and some cleaning arrangements, automatic cleaning arrangements, basically, and lightning arresting systems. And all these things cannot be given to the residential sector. So, and residential benchmark price is very low. So again, client is asking for the lowest cost and very good guaranteed generation and all these things, which is cannot be possible. So it needs to be streamlined and standardized. So my concern, I have already told that it needs to be on one stream, and we have to educate our clients more and more way that government is already advertising the solarizing their roof, because the most of the roofs are their idle asset, and if they are generating some incomes for them, it is already giving some input cut, so they are getting benefits. But right now in Gujarat it will be around 15% to 20% range. So we need to look at those things also.
Thank you, Mr. Narya. As per the discussion, the overarching theme that I'm finding is mainly revolving around the policy issues, the subsidy challenges, the MSME installation challenges. And leading to that is the customer experience, which is getting hampered right now. And a lot of it is linked to the awareness and the enablers which are there in the market. The enablers are different stakeholders, which can be leading to a financer, the DISCOM, the government, the agencies, and the end consumers. The awareness has to be developed on the main idea of what a solar can give them and how that message can be given through technology. And I believe all of us, we have highlighted the major challenges that we are facing as of now. But again, we have a hope that due to the support of the government, we can, and the targets that we have taken, all these execution challenges can be mitigated in the coming few years. And we will be able to achieve the targets that that have been highlighted by the government. With this, I would want to close this discussion and get the floor open for any question and answers. Thank you so much.